The safest way to school, to the store, to the church, to the movie, to any place. Made by the Pennsylvania State College with the help of the State College Public Schools. And told by me. My name is David Lane. This picture is about something we did in our school this year. And I want to show you what it was. It all started one day when we asked our teacher in the street. Do you know what she did? She took us outside, the whole class, to show us things we ought to know about crossing the streets. She showed us about stop signs that are put up at busy street corners. She took us to a corner where there is a traffic light and showed us how we must cross only when the light is green and to wait at the curb while it's yellow or red. A school safety patrol member met us at one corner to show us how he watches to see when it is safe for us to cross. He explained that we should always wait on the corner until he tells us that the street is clear. But he said to be sure to watch for ourselves, too, and to stay in the crosswalks. Do you know what crosswalks are? They're lines painted across the street to show us where we're supposed to walk. Corners where policemen direct the traffic are the safest. She said they make cars stop while we cross, but she told us always to wait till the policeman motions us to go, and always to watch for turning cars, no matter what corner we're on. In class, our teacher had us move our desks together around a big table.
Yesterday, we saw how to watch for cars and how to tell when it's safe to cross. We saw that some corners are safer places to cross than others. Corners where there are stop signs and traffic lights, and corners where policemen and school safety patrol help us to cross. Today, we'll put into use some of the things we saw and talked about yesterday. Now, who can tell me what this is? Betty?
A street map.
That's right. These lines show the streets around our school. Now, here's a little model of our school. Here's the front door. Can anybody tell me where our classroom is? Edward?
These two windows right up here.
That's right. Now, I'll put this down on the map just where our school is. Here's the sidewalk from the front door to the street. Who knows the name of this street?
That's 4th Avenue.
Yeah.
I live on 4th Avenue right across from the school.
All right, Bobby. I'll write that on the map. Now, can you show us just where you live, Bobby? Suppose this little model represents your house. Put it down on the big map just where your house is.
Right here.
Now, will you draw your path home with this red crayon? We will each draw our path home with a different colored crayon. And that way, when we're through, each person will know which is his own path. Now, Bobby, what path do you take?
Well, I come out to school and walk, but I don't cut right across there. I walk over to the corner.
What street is that?
That's Pine Street.
All right, I'll write that on the map. Pine Street.
Then I cross at Pine Street and walk down the other side of the street to my house.
That's very good, Bobby. It would be shorter for Bobby if he went across the street in the middle of the block directly to his house. But it's wiser for him to cross at the corner. Who knows why? Alice?
Because there's a school safety patrol boy there, and he helps him to cross.
Yes, that's right. Now, this little cutout represents the patrol member. I'll put him here in the corner of 4th and Pine Street to remind us that a patrol is there to help us. Who knows another reason for Bobby to cross at the corner? Harry?
Well, if he didn't go to the corner, he would have to walk between parked cars, and that would be dangerous.
That's right. Do you have anything to add, Bobby?
Well, the safest place to cross is at the corner, right at the middle of the block, just like it says on that poster.
cross only at quarters. That's where the crosswalks are. That's where the drivers look.
Fine, Bobby. Those are some very good reasons why we should all cross at corners instead of in the middle of the block. Now, who else wants to show us his path home? Someone who lives farther away than Bobby. You do, don't you, Betty?
Yes, I live at Maple, just past Third.
Right there. This is Maple Street, and this is Third Avenue.
All right, Betty, I'll write that on the map. Maple Street. Third Avenue. What street is this?
That's Oak Street. There's a traffic light right at this corner.
That's right. I'll put a traffic light on the map to help us remember it. Now, Betty, draw your path home with this green crayon.
Well, I go up 4th Avenue to Oak Street, then cross the street here and here. Go on down 4th Avenue on the other side to Maple. Down Maple, past 3rd Avenue to my house.
Do you find any of the streets especially hard to cross?
Well, I used to. I used to come down and cross Oak Street first, then wait for the light to change and cross 4th Avenue. But I found out that most of the cars that come down Oak Street turn left onto 4th Avenue, like this.
Yes, that's the route of the main highway. How did you change your path?
Well, now I cross to the other side of 4th Avenue first, and then cross Oak Street. That way I miss all the cars that turn left.
That's fine, Betty. Betty has been noticing how the cars go, and that's why she's found an easier way to go home. Now let's see what Betty has along her way that helps her, and what she has that she must watch. Who wants to suggest something? Julie?
There's a traffic light on Oak Street.
That's right. What else?
And there is a stop sign on 4th Avenue and Maple Street.
Yes, we'll put a stop sign there. 4th Avenue is a through street. Why do stop signs help, Grace?
Because the cars slow down and stop, then we can cross.
We have to watch for turning cars, too.
Grace and Earl are right. Stop signs are a big help, though we must always be watchful ourselves. Betty could go home up 3rd Avenue. Would that be a good way?
No, there are no stop signs on 3rd Avenue, and I think it would be better to go up 4th.
I think you're right, David. Can we make any rules from what we've seen about Betty's path home? Jack?
Yes, watch for turning cars.
All right, I'll write that on the board. Watch for turning cars. Alice?
Cross at corners where there are stop signs.
And traffic lights, too.
That's right, so we have two rules. Watch for turning cars, and choose corners where there is some help for you, such as stop signs and traffic lights.
Then Joan, Edward, and Grace put their houses on the map and drew their paths home. We talked about what was good and bad in them. I got to thinking about the way I always went home. I live a little farther from school than most of the children. When my turn came, I had just about made up my mind to change my path.
Where do you live, David?
I live on 7th Avenue, just below Main Street, right here.
That's a long way from school. What path do you take? Draw your path home with this brown crayon.
Well, I have been going down 4th Avenue to Main Street, up Main Street to 7th Avenue, crossing there and going to my house. But I've been thinking, Mrs. Wilson.
Yes?
I've once had trouble crossing at 7th Avenue. Just this morning on my way to school, I had to wait there a long time before I could cross. Main Street is a very busy street, especially at 7th Avenue.
That's always been my hardest corner to cross, but just now listening to the class, I thought of something.
I think it would be better to cross Main Street at 6th Avenue instead of 7th and come on home this way.
Why is that, David?
Well, for one thing, there's usually a policeman at 6th Avenue and there aren't as many cars turning.
That's right. We'll put a policeman down on that corner.
And I think there are more people crossing there, too, and it might be easier for me to cross with them.
Suppose you draw your path home that way, David. I think your idea is very good. And there's some other good ideas in David's path home. For instance, why is it better for David to cross on the north side of Main Street rather than on the south side? Joan?
If he walked down the south side of the street, he'd have to cross Howard Place and Lawson Place. They stop on Main Street right here.
Yes, that's right. By choosing that path, he has only two streets to cross instead of four. Can we make a rule from that? Pete?
Would the rule be always choose your way home when there are fewest corners to cross?
Yes, that's right. If you can, choose a way with the fewest corners to cross. Now, Alice, what is your path home?
Each person in our group draws path home with a different colored crayon. We helped each other find better ways to go. We worked out a lot of rules about how to choose the safest way to and from school. When we had finished the map, it showed how everybody walks home from school. Even our teacher's path was on it. We decided it would be a good idea for each person to have a small copy of the map with his own way home. Then he could take it with him and show it to his father and mother. We picked a committee to help Mrs. Wilson make them. I was on it. Betty said she would help too, and so did some of the others. That afternoon, our committee got together, and we made up a letter to our parents to put on the little map. Mrs. Wilson helped us draw the streets, but we put in the names and other things ourselves. Then we made enough copies for the whole class, and a few extra, too. In class the next day, we passed out the copies of our map so we could draw our path home on it. We had the big map right in front of us all the time, so we'd be sure to get our path drawn in just the same way.
When you've drawn your path on the little map, I'll put my name on it to show that it is just like the path you drew on the big map yesterday. David has already finished his. This is the way it should look. This line shows his path home from school. Yours should look like this, but with your own path drawn on it. Now take your maps home with you today and show them to your parents. Ask them to look them over carefully and read the message you've written on it. I think your parents will be very interested in what you've said.
I knew mine would, because we had talked about it the night before. I told them about my new way of crossing Main Street at 6th Avenue. They liked it. So that evening, I showed them my map with my path drawn on it. Dad read the letter we had written. This is what it said. Dear Mother and Dad, this is my map of the way I go to school. I think it is the safest way. Will one of you walk to school with me and see if you think that I have chosen the safest way? Then if you do, will you sign your name at the bottom? With love, David. Dad thought that walking to school with me was a good idea, and he said he'd do it the very next day if we could get an early start. I said we sure could. So the next morning, we started out with plenty of time. We walked on the north side of Main Street, so we didn't have to cross Howard Place and Lawson Place. I told him that we all planned our paths, so we would have the fewest corners to cross. I showed him how I crossed Main Street at 6th Avenue now, instead of 7th, because there's a policeman there, and because more people cross there. I showed him how stop signs make corners safer to cross, because cars have to slow down and stop. But I told him we always watch for cars anyway, especially cars that turn. When we crossed the street, I showed him the way we watch for cars. First look to the left. When it's all clear, we start across. And of course, I told him we always stay in the crosswalk. Traffic lights make corners pretty safe to cross. But I showed Dad how we always watch for cars anyway, and how we cross only when the light is green. He told me that that was fine, but to watch for cars myself and not to depend on anybody else. Dad liked our school safety patrol and the way everybody cooperated with the patrol member. We got to school in plenty of time. Dad thought I'd done a good job in choosing my way. And to prove it, he signed his name on my map. And then he told me something which I think is pretty important. He said that no matter where I go, there is a safest way. There's a safest way to the church, for instance. And Dad thought it would be a good idea for me to figure out what it is. And he said I ought to think about my path to the movies on Saturdays to make sure I'm going the safest way. He said that whenever I go anywhere, the first thing I should do is stop and think and decide which is the safest way. Well, that's what we did in our school this year. I think any school could do it, don't you?